mentally architecting the city. Cosmic egg, Rira, revolution, evolution. And the avatar, functionings. The human vessel, stem cells, sites and cities, Osiris, the king of the dead, the reset of death once. Now, it seems to me that, because I know everything is mine, and I see these reflections in front of me, that a lot of beings are resetted over time, and we are living in a realm, in an imaginational realm, where a lot of beings have been resetted over time, and they don't even know, they didn't notice what was going on. Because not many beings have actually the original workings, which are that we live in a mindful, mind-empty realm, in a magic realm, in an imaginational realm. And a lot of beings just give their complete powers, their complete essence to the magic of somebody else. They exist for the benefits of others. And because of this, no one is really standing up in this world to get out of it and to architect it from above. To architect it basically only with your mind. You architect the city, your star constellation, the paths you travel in your brain, only for yourself. Because certainly it is about the community aspect, but what I'm seeing is that the further we go into the matrix, into the system, the more we separate ourselves from the original thing, which was your own avatar. And this is why I'm stressing that so much. I'm stressing Shivamukkabha urine therapy so much, because and fasting and the still waters and the clean diet, also, you know, sun gazing. But many, like, of course, many, every avatar functions differently. So I'm not claiming that I'm knowing what is good for you. But for many beings, it would be that you probably just should empty yourself out more. You should fast more. You should maybe have more capacity in your mind. And you then this is when you start to see these spiritual things around you, which are going on all the time, but you're just not aware of them. And like I said, I'm Osiris, the king of the reset of dead ones. Because all these needles that we produce, see, and I can't even speak very clearly. I'm trying to speak as clearly and without so many metaphors. But if I'm using certain words, I will be blocked, or I will be like, things will start to vanish. So this is why I know I architect the site, the city, the viewpoint from above. And so let's start with the original workings one more time. The original workings are that you are self-sustaining, and you should learn to move your body. I don't know what kind of fashion you move yourself. I don't even know, like, if my voice is for you. I don't know. But I manifest these things because I speak openly about them, and I'm sure that I am the only one on this island where I'm constructing my own world because of the following aspect. The following aspect is that it seems to me that because I don't see much mirrors produced on the Instagram, or I don't know if somebody else exists, I don't know. Still, I have certain programs run in my mind, for example, this loyalty aspect or this long-term aspect, long-term relationships in every degree. And sometimes that's also, you know, a slaving process, a slaving and energy vampirism that seems to be going on, you know. Because everybody should be able to take care of themselves. Everybody should be able to work on their own. And this starts with the most fundamental things, which is Shivam Bukalpa, being self-sustaining, moving yourself, and taking care of your own things that you ingest, you know, taking care also of your mind space. And I'm doing that because this is why I'm starting to clean up more things on the internet. I'm starting to clean up my space, you know. Less material consumption is what I would say, from my perception, a thing to follow. Use things more until they break, you know. You use it until you lose it. Because this would be, so to say, beneficial for the whole thing. Because nature by itself corrects itself. And we are not doing that when we're producing things which are like we just throw them away. We get them and then we throw them away. And the fasting, like I said, is a very good practice to empty out your avatar, to become more mindful. And it's easy. It's very easy. And if it works for your own human vessel, for your avatar, it works for nature. It works for society. It works for everything. There is basically no difference between even any yoga style. There is no difference between nature and society or technology. And obviously there is, you know, and I have to sometimes separate things. But from a very high perception, this is all toys. This is a mud race. This is a mud flood completely. Human beings are just rubbing themselves in the freaking mud. And to get out of here, this is why I'm saying I'm Osiris, the king of the reset dead ones. I'm ruling the underworld. Because these beings don't even know. And it's not about this amount of currency that somebody has in the background or somebody has not. It's not about that. It's about your mind. It's about the original workings. And to speak transparently about that. You know, all these, for example, these fallen, so to say, fallen masters. Do they exist? Is somebody of them even real? Are they just a projected hologram? Is anybody real? Because I have these thoughts and I'm... There are not many beings who seem to be very intelligent with what they actually mirror out, what they say. And this is why I'm getting to the conclusion that I'm surrounded by holograms, which are basically empty and they're just mirroring what we do, what I do. So what kind of image do I represent myself with, but also what kind of image do you consume? What kind of image do you mirror out? If you become aware of that, this is how you literally change the world. Because from my point of view, learning is a mirroring process. And we are all, nobody basically stopped learning until you die. You could just say, I don't want to learn something. Well, if you want to go very deep into the system, you have to do certain licenses. But to get out of the world, to get into magic, to get into alchemy, to get into the rooted arts, to get into hermeticism, to get into mind control, you know? And then basically mind empowerment. Because this is what I'm giving you here. I'm giving you your own power back, which gives... One more time, it's about do yoga and drink your urine. And it would do the most magic for you that you could ever experience. Do yoga in the sunlight and put urine onto your skin and soak in the light. So you would understand this alchemical process, this alchemical vessel that you have. You would understand. See, and this is the bizarre thing with it, that the system is not giving you these codes. And it's like, oh, you have to figure out for yourself to get out of here. Well, I don't think so. I'm pretty sure that we have to have beings who mirror these things out. And like I said, and if I'm going in very, very deep, all these graffitis around me, all these children, these beautiful beings around me, what they have printed onto their clothings, the number shields, like, are they called number shields? I am power, I am energy, I am balance, I am passion, I am decision. Yeah. So of course I decide what to do, you know, and I see these signs in front of me, in the city, in the sighty. But to make it a very clean, free spirit place and to give basically the power, you could do whatever you would like to do, but you are already doing the workings, but you're not aware of it, you're not conscious about it. If you would become conscious about what you do, continue doing that, but be aware that you mirror that out. Is that what you would like to see? I don't go to the grocery store to buy food because I know basically it drags me down. It is an amount of energy that I can transmute to become a mutant, to mutate that into what I would like to see. But that's a very high alchemical perception, and you have to be very strong to do that. See, and this is why I'm like, okay, I eat if something is offered to me, and if I feel intuitively drawn to that. If I'm not feeling like that, I don't consume it. Why should I consume that? So know your alchemy, get into Shivamukalpa and move your body, do movement. Yeah, you're not motivated, but see, that's the bizarre thing. And then what you keep doing is you mirror your brain with something which is you, because you are everything that you take a look into, that you hear. But if you would get to the kinematic, for example, let's use the kinematic yoga again. It really is not about the specific yoga style, because if you become enlightened and if you know, every movement is the same because you have one body. Now the question is, what kind of movements do fit into your lifestyle? So what kind of flow do you produce? And that's what you mirror out. And I'm not claiming that my yoga style is the best. It's in that time frame the best for me right here, right now. And then I switch it up, then I do something different. You know, this is how basically what chaos is, but I structure it. I need more structure. I need to clean things up more. Things should be very clean. And then I speak transparently, directly about what I would like to see. So the kinematic yoga is basically, I mean, different yoga styles are for different things, right? But what happens to you, if you do a certain yoga style, is your experience. And your experience, you could do the exact same things that I do and you could have a completely different experience. You could take in the same substances that I ingest and you could have a completely different experience. Because you are not me. But the bizarre thing is, if we realize we are the same. So the kinematic yoga is for me very much about realizing my mind potential, and that I'm working with my head, my dome. And sometimes, you know, I have to, but this seems to be one of the most intelligent things that I do, to just mirror my voice and to explain things through the word. Because if I'm very good at explaining things, you just have to work on your capacity to listen. And then, of course, to integrate that. But from my point of view, I'm very clear minded when I speak, and then it just rambles outside of me. And sure, sometimes I have to hold myself together, and you know, it's all part of the process, you know. But in the end, it's easy, it's very easy. Consume less material things. You will attract over time definitely what is the best thing for you. That's a brainer. That's definitely a fact. Move yourself. Drink more water. Drink your urine. Go out into the sunlight and become like katana, like strong, like the song here from Schwangel that I will give you in the end. Now we can put this universe and put it inside a very tiny head and fold it, and we can put this universe inside a very tiny head and just fold it. And we can put this universe inside a very tiny head and fold it. And we can put this universe inside a very tiny head and fold it. And we can put this universe inside a very tiny head and fold it. And we can put this universe inside a very tiny head and fold it. And what you would get then into is a giant, strong katana which was folded so many times that it constructs through killing, because it would just go through everything. you just go through things because your universe is so freaking strong and folded together, molded together, that nothing can break it. So enjoy listening to the Spangle song. Like I used to say, stay calm, stay open, try out new things, and enjoy living your life, constructing the sight.
Ich werde jetzt auf meinen Teller irgendwelche servieren.